Hi, I'm Jennifer Hunter, and I'd like to share with you several of my paintings that are on their way to the Traveling the West show down in Dallas, Texas. The first painting here is called Horse Medicine. Horse Medicine is because this horse was a gift to Chief David Bald Eagle. He had had a horse very much like this.
And we raise mostly horses. We had horses. My grandfather had horses, beautiful paid horses. And I've got, right now I've got paints and Appaloosies and Strawberry Roans.
Mm-hmm.
Those three colors.
He was a big horse. I mean, he had muscles. He was quite the... He's a well-built horse, and boy, when he walked with pride. And when Dad was on him, he just looked so good, because he was at the Days of 76 and Rodeo, and he always rode a really beautiful horse, and Chief was that beautiful horse. And Dad was on him bareback with his war bonnet and his buckskin outfit, and he even had a cup of coffee. The horse was good enough that Dad could hold a cup of coffee all the way through the parade.
Uh-huh. Yeah, my favorite was Pate, who he called Chief. Him and I was in the movies a couple times. And I lost him 2 years ago. He died.
Chief has left this world, and Dad was really down. He was really so sad. He really, really had a connection with that horse, a really strong connection. My husband, Chris Ravenshead, he made a song. He made a Lakota song for Chief, because he knew Chief too. He also knew Chief. And when we stood over the grave and my husband sang that song, LaVon and my father, they had tears in their eyes and they were crying because they were saying goodbye to an old friend. A very, very close friend, and it hurt them to see him go. The other day when they brought Medicine Man, Friday, when they brought Medicine Man to show to Dad, Dad was so happy. Medicine Man, he said, my friend came back, he said, you know. And he was so happy he cried, and I was lucky to be part of it.
The chief named the horse Medicine Boy. The horse is actually a medicine hat. That's the type of coat color pattern that it has. It's a pinto, you know, being a brown and white horse. But a medicine hat has a white face. It has colored on its forehead and its ears over the pole that's at the horse's forehead. So quite often, a medicine hat horse was held in high regard. It had magical properties. It protected its owner. So when they rode it in battle, they felt that they were being protected. And they thought of that medicine hat kind of like a war bonnet. The way the warrior had a war bonnet, the horse had the markings that gave him a war bonnet. Some medicine hats also had blue eyes, which made them even more special because the eyes were the color of the sky. Quite often these horses were reserved for the higher ranking men in the tribe, like the medicine man and the chief. So this is Horse Medicine, an oil painting featuring Chief David Bald Eagle and his daughter Zola, who is holding a horse dance stick.
The headdress is held, you know, in a very high reverence, you know.
Yeah.
And those feathers mean a lot of things, you know. They're not just sitting up there because it looks good. And so it's a big thing when you wear it. A guy that would have been wearing, you know, the headdress, would have been a leader, would have been the chief, or, you know, leader going into battle, whatever the case. And that would have been because of his accomplishments or his feats, you know. And the fact that people, you know, already recognized and looked at him in that way, And so there's like a confidence, I think, that comes when you're wearing that. And I feel like there's a little something comes over me when I put that on. And I'm, you know, not a chief or a leader to do what we're doing out here, recreate some things so that we can tell stories. I think there should be a confidence in whoever's going to wear that and, you know, wear it like if we were in 1880 and, you know, you were leading. I mean, you know, Crazy Horse, Quanah Parker, these guys were confident men that, you know, I don't think they were second-guessing anything. They were just, they knew what they wanted to do.
This oil painting features my friend Cody as a Lakota warrior, and it is called Lakota Pride. Cody painted this horse as a warrior would paint a horse before he goes into battle. The ring around the horse's eye would help the horse see better, according to the Indians. And he's wearing a war bonnet and a breastplate that's made of bone. So this is an oil painting called Lakota Pride. In the summer of 94, I learned to drive. It was a 4-speed with 8 ears and 16 legs. I was driving mules, 4 across, driving a covered wagon for the first time on a wagon train. And that was a pretty magical experience because you had to steer those mules. You had the reins in each hand, and if you wanted to turn left, you'd pull back on the left and you'd let the right go slack. And turning right, you'd do the opposite. It was a very interesting experience to be on a wagon train. The days were long. You did about 20 miles a day. You felt every bump in the road. We were on gravel roads. Part of the time we were going through fields, grassy fields, and you would look out across the prairie and you could imagine what that might have been like for the pioneers, looking out on that horizon, seeing that vast prairie of grass. You would stop for the day in the afternoon. You left early in the morning because you wanted to get going in the cool part of the day before the heat really came on. So by 2 or 3 o'clock in the afternoon, you were stopping for the day. So this painting is based on my experiences of being on the wagon trains. And this represents having stopped at the end of the day. The father's taking care of the oxen. The children are dancing and playing music. One of the girls is reading. So this is what it might be like. I imagine it might be like this, to be part of a family on the Oregon Trail crossing the Great Prairies. So this is an oil painting, A Song for the Prairie. There's a place in Colorado that's near and dear to my heart. And this would be it. This is Rocky Mountain National Park. I was privileged to be an artist in residence at Rocky Mountain National Park and enjoy staying there in a historic cabin. And I actually have a painting in the National Parks collection of Rocky Mountain National Park of their park dedication. The dedication was in 1915, 100 years ago. So in celebration of Rocky's 100th birthday, I did this watercolor painting. And it is titled Touring the New Rocky Mountain National Park, 1915. What you see in this painting are Stanley steamer cars. Those were invented by F.O. Stanley and his brother. They were a big part of the tourism of the new Rocky Mountain National Park. The trains would bring the tourists up to Loveland, Colorado, and then the hotels had the Stanley steamers and they would bring the tourists up to the park. There were also Stanley steamer buses that carried maybe, I don't know, 8 or 10 people, and they would tour the park. So this is a scene that shows a family, a couple families here, out enjoying the beauty of the day in this nice sunlit meadow with the Stanley steamer cars. And this is titled Touring the New Rocky Mountain National Park, 1915. This watercolor painting is called Dad's New Stanley. This shows a little girl and her father in their new Stanley steamer car in Rocky Mountain National Park. So this car is about 100 years old. I've had the honor of riding in this car, actually. This is the car that I used in both paintings for the Stanley steamers here. And it's incredibly quiet and incredibly smooth. The Stanley steamer is a steam car because you put water in it. It's got a boiler, it creates steam pressure, like a steam locomotive, and that is what powers the car. You do have some fuel in there that you're burning to create the steam, but it is actually the steam that powers the car. Interesting thing is when you blow the whistle on it, it sounds like a steam whistle on a train, so that's kind of neat. But it's a really smooth riding, very quiet car. You don't have the engine noise like you have in modern cars, it's just really quiet. You're running on the steam pressure. So it's very interesting. This car would be about 100 years old. And this is the original color, original paint. This car is original. It has not been redone. So this is actually how it was at the time. So this features a Stanley steamer in Rocky Mountain National Park, which is 100 years old. And so the car and the park kind of go together. So this is Dad's new Stanley. Thank you for letting me share my artwork with you. All of these paintings will be available for sale in the Traveling the West exhibition and sale in Dallas, Texas at Southwest Galleries the third week in October. So if you're going to be in the area, stop on by. It's going to be a great show, 175 artists, and all paintings about traveling the West in all the ways that people traveled, by horse, by train, by covered wagon, old cars, airplanes. So it'll be quite an interesting show. So I'm looking forward to it, and I hope I see you there.